Challenge 2023. Once the drivers make, if you're tuning in on track tune, drivers are making their way down the backstretch, they will get the green flag on the exit of turn four. Drivers cannot fire until they get to that orange cone, and Speedy throws the green flag. Side for second, who is stuck on the outside, coming to inside. Lee Davis is watching them right back in the fourth position. Wait to see what's going to happen. Still happy out front, coming around for lap number one. Side by side for the lead. To the right, race on the back, first to the advantage of Cummins. Who is going to try to follow Cummins on through? Who is to the inside of Happy? Happy watches up. Was there in the 77th car. Wait to see what the official call is, but from my vantage point, it doesn't appear that Matthew knew that Lee Davis in the 77th car was doing it inside. Our lap counter is not working. We'll be back 2 laps in. We're going to go single file restart here. Green flag for the number 13. A lot of smoke coming out of the back of Kenny Ull. He's going to pull the zero car to the infield. Calvin's pulled the zero car. Go yellow for the officials to check the track and see if the zero pool put any fluid down, and then also make sure that there's no flames under the zero hood. So tough start to the first heat race. Five to go. Tim Rush in fourth, Ronnie Abney fifth, Jeff Anderson sixth, Jeff Sofield seventh, being scored in the eighth position, Kenny Ull in the zero car. A little smoke coming out of the 19 of Bobby Rowland. Hopefully it's nothing too serious. He's currently second in the points and just finished second in the heat. So problems for the 19. Keep your eyes on the 56, that blue number 56 in the back row. That's one fast car that's going to have to make his way up through the field. had a lot of wins and a lot of laps around Auburndale Speedway as the field's going to make their way around turn 3 and 4 to join us on track 2. We're going to take the green flag on the exit of the town for you. Zone. James Wright the third. Dave Kamefield. Problems for Ronnie Abney in the 64. He's going to try to make the second heat race for the 64 fans. Rounds out the field in the sixth position. 14-01 of Joe Pites, one of our former and current Scrambler drivers. Joe Pites in the 01, normally drives the 2J in the Scrambler. So he's going to try his hand at the pure stock tonight.
Set on the even out press.
Group 5th, Ronnie Abney 6th, Fatback Robert 7th, round out the field, Joe Kleitz in the 2, I'm sorry, the 01. Field being shown 1 to go, next time by, gonna go green. Michael Nanfeld, 9th, and Joe Sunday rounds out the field in 10th. One lap to go. Speedy looks like he's got a little helper up there. Going to help him throw the green flag for the Crown Vicks. So we got a youngster flagman and a youngster on the front row, 14-year-old Tyler Landis in the K-29. Back-to-back wins in a mini sprint. Going to see what he can do in the Crown Vic. Green flag in the air for Tyler Landis. Second, looks like Jonathan Moss can clear out the target for the second. Third, and that one now in for the quarter. Side by side, that 53 to Wilson, then Wilson.
Thank you.
manufacturer, Flanders, walked up just a little bit high and opened the door for Jonathan Walsh to take the lead. Jonathan Walsh. Flanders coming home second. Roger Sargent third. George Ford third. Fourth. Kyle Case fifth. Dylan Bigley sixth in the 25. James Bristol seventh in the 17B. Cole Bristol 8th in the 18, Daniel Wilson 9th in the 53. Dalton DeGroff, Mike Wilson, Sean Osteen, Kyle Rice in the 7K, Jimmy McLeod in the nice looking blue and white 04, right there tagging the tail end of the field. Cousin right behind him, Dalton DeGroff in the 7, Cameron Maynard in the 13, side by side over there. Caution as Jimmy McLeod goes around, a little bit of help from another driver. I'm not sure which 7 is Dalton DeGroff. I think that was Dalton DeGroff that went behind the wall. I think he had a flat tire. That's what washed him up high onto Jimmy McLeod, and McLeod was just the wrong place at the wrong time. One lap down, 7 to go. Dustin Wilson, Kyle Rice, front row. Dennis Wilson coming home second in the 42W. Sean Osteen third. Kyle Rice fourth. Mike Wilson fifth. Kalen Maynard sixth. Jimmy McLeod in the 04 is seventh being scored. Eighth is Dalton DeGroff. So this time we're going to have a short intermission along with a autograph session for the super late models. So it'll be just a few minutes to get the super late models lined up here on the front stretch. And once they're all in their position, vehicles are safely turned off, we're going to let everybody on out to go visit your favorite super late model driver. Or if you don't have a favorite, it'll be a good time to pick one.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Driver, start your engines!
on the binders as King was just about a groove or two up high around those door. Third place car, unfortunately for Tim Sozio, as we approached the lap car, maybe got on the binders a bit too hard, and around goes the 33S of Tim Sozio. Had a good run going in the third position.
John, you started on the outside of the front row, we're able to put this thing to the inside and put DeCare in your rearview mirror. We're in 35 clean and green laps out front. Had a restart with 15 to go, but you were able to shut the door, and DeCare fell to the back a little bit, and you had Schofield coming here, but you were able to keep this hot rod out front of him. Had quite the car tonight. Who do you want to thank?
I want to thank my wife, because she always hating if I don't win, so she ain't here tonight, but I just want to let her know I brought it home. I appreciate Jeff racing me clean, TJ. I want to thank my mom, my dad, my crew chief Rick, Green Motion.
Oh, here we go.
And I want to thank my fans much for coming out.
Congratulations on a good run. See if we can do it later on tonight. John Guy in the 42.
That ain't racing
when
you're moving.
Last week I was in everybody's victory lane picture and they didn't like that. So let's see if I can get over here where I have a good. Possibly. Jeff, on that last restart, you were able to get this car in the right position, get it come up in the runner up position. It fired off right where you needed on the last restart, maybe a couple more laps, so we could have had a good battle for the lead.
Yeah, Jonathan was sporty, so I just wanted to let him know I was there at the end. I don't know if I could have passed him. Maybe if we had a restart on the outside, I could have held him down. But, we had a rocket. You know, it was pretty good. I rode there at the beginning because I knew there would be a caution towards the end. And, it showed pretty good. So we'll see how the second one rolls out. But we're good.
Took pretty good care of the tires for the second race?
Yeah, you know me. If I ain't sideways, I ain't racing.
All right, congratulations. Daniel Webster coming home in the third position. The car was here where you needed it at the end. Unfortunately, your team car, he had a good run going and had problems there where the lap car went around, maybe flat-spotted tires. I'm not sure exactly what happened there, but you were able to make a good effort for the other team car and put in third position.
Yeah, I hate that it took his misfortune to get us in position there at the end, but yeah, the car wasn't as good in the race as I was hoping for, but a couple lanes opened up on the restart, and I sent it on the 88 pretty hard to fill that hole, and it worked out good and came home with the top three.
Yeah, congratulations. We'll see you later on tonight. Who do you want to thank real quick?
Yeah, obviously my dad. It's his car. He puts a lot into this, everything. All my guys for coming out and helping tonight. We decided yesterday, like lunchtime, to come race. I had to get it out of the trailer. It was still loaded up from last week, and we were up pretty late last night getting two of them ready. And brought two fast cars. Just got to figure out what happened to the first one, and we'll be back later tonight.
All right, you had a heck of a start to 2023. Bring it back out later tonight for the second feature with two 33s. Who are we going to pull here? Okay, Dan Pendant Tech, Daniel Webster will start the front row pole on the second race as John Guy pulled a 42.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
From the fence, children and adults, please back away from the fence. Could be still hot parts still on this car. Driver is okay. Jeff Anderson advised and safety personnel that he is okay. Hard hit. That car just kind of turned right on the Dirty Bacon Motorsports 10J. He owns a couple cars out here, the 64 Ronnie Abney, the 91 of Tim Russian's other team cars as well. So tough break for Jeff Anderson. Car just kind of turned right, going right into turn four. I was watching him, and I thought it was just kind of washing up high, and I thought he was going to grab a hold of it and hold on to it, but unfortunately, the car just wouldn't turn. So obviously, something broke in the steering of the 10 Junior of Jeff Anderson.
Uh-huh.
next time by. Your front row consists of Lee Davis on the inside in the 77, Ronnie Abney outside, Tim Russian, Nick Cummins, Jeff Sofield, Kelly Hahn in the 8. 6 cars to settle this for 33 more laps. I'm sorry. exited turn three and enters turn three and four. Checker flag in the air here. Nick Cummins. Abby second, Lee Davis third, Tiny Russian fourth, and John Sofield rounds out the top five in the 47.
Climb out of this car, your feature winner, come from behind bonus, Nick Cummins in the 2C, took this thing from all the way in the back up to the front for the 25-lap feature event. Nick Cummins, your current points leader, is picking up right where you left off. Nick, trying to put a lock on early in the season in the points.
Yeah, had a hiccup last week, but it's all right. Tried to get myself a little more competition. That's why I started so far back, see how well I could come through the field without touching anybody, and that's what we did.
All right, congratulations. Who do you want to thank tonight?
I'd like to thank APE Engine Performance, my dad, my brother John, his wife April. They set the car up. He sets the tires up. My dad does the motor work. APE does the motor work. That's it.
All right, congratulations. Another solid win. Ronnie Abney coming home in the second position, pulling double duty. Gonna see what you can do later on tonight. Got a podium on this one right after this, so we better get you on back there.
Yeah, we fought a lot of motor problems this year, but I'd like to thank my mom and dad, Devin, Jacob, Jimmy, Jeff Anderson with Dirty Making Motorsports for letting me drive his car.
Yeah, he had a hard hit. Hopefully he can get that car repaired.
I hope so. We'll do what we can.
All right, congratulations, Ronnie. Go on back there and get in that pure stock. Try to get another podium finish up here and talk with us. Ronnie Abney in the 64.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Fields lights are off. Fields being shown one to go. If you're listening to us on track two, the field is making their way down the back stretch to enter turn three and get the green flag on the exit of turn four, where we've got some films placed throughout the track. Green flags in the air. Side by side as they go into turn two, exit of turn two, because they're only able to horsepower down the backstretch. Contact, around goes Preston Davis. Not sure what exactly. Preston Davis and Craig Cazone kind of door slammed each other a little bit, and I think Preston Davis got hooked up for just a second, but now we've got the 23 and the 4 hooked together as well. So Preston Davis able to continue on, possibly. Davis going over top of the wall. This all transpired when the leaders got together on the exit of turn four there. Kind of hooked. They were almost hooked side by side as they kind of touched doors a little bit. And Preston Davis broke loose and everybody behind him basically had nowhere to go. That's from my vantage point. Maybe we'll have a better look at it when Speedway Video posts the videos tomorrow. Fatback Roberts in the 14, nowhere to go. Brandon Love, nowhere to go. Bones, nowhere to go. So a couple innocent victims here stopped on the front stretch. As we're going red flag, as we're going to try to unhook the 23, the 4, and the 14. All kind of accordion effect there. Preston Davis in the 89 did go behind the wall. Bones is outside of his car, taking a look at it, surveying the damage as they're trying to break everything loose there. Going to see if he can continue on in that Bobby Mobley Motorsports number 23. Bones getting a little bit of hurry back into the car. Heavy damage to the rear of Dushire. Gonna push the 14 of Fatback Roberts to the back behind the wall. One lap before we go back to green. Bowen's gonna make his way back out in the 23. We'll be anxious to see what the 23-89 do. A couple fast cars stuck at the tail end of the field. Meanwhile, your front row, Craig Cazone, James Wright. Thank you. break his own second, rolls the tire first, gets the same score. Nau Sea said finish off, and that's the rounds after top. Sixth, Ronnie Roop seventh, Ronnie Abney eighth, Josh Korniak ninth, Joe Kleiss tenth, Brent Love being scored 11th, Fatback Roberts 12th, Bobby Klinke 13th, Abe Canfield rounds out the field in the 14th position.
Getting out of his car, your feature winner, James Wright III, in the number 56. James coming home with another victory. Not sure what transpired on that lap one, but on the after the complete restart, you were able to get this thing out front, man, and set the sails. Who do you want to thank?
I want to thank my dad. He busted his tail. Last time we were here, we got the car killed over on the back straightaway, and he's got this thing looking, I mean, so good. Charlie Brown and those guys at Auto Tech Collision, Nearmore Machine Shop, my buddy Big Ron. Thanks, Danny, for coming out here helping me. You know, I really want to thank God. I prayed. My dad kind of reminded me this was my aunt's birthday. She passed away a few years ago, but she'd wait up on me every Saturday night and wait for one of these trophies. So this one's for PJ.
Oh, congratulations. Greg, lap one, I don't know really what happened. Looked like you and Preston Davis, some guy somehow got hooked together side by side. He was able to break it loose, but unfortunately some of the field collected behind him. But you were able to keep your mindset on the restart and put this thing out front, keep it out front. It's hard to hold off that 56, but able to come home with a runner-up position.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what happened on that restart. We made a little contact in the middle of the corner, and then I don't know if he got stuck on me, and then or people piled him into me, or I'm not really sure. But hate it for everybody that happened to. The second restart there, James got a nose on me, and I knew that I was in trouble. That car, he was better than me. He was going to beat me probably regardless, but I gave it to him on the start, so that stinks. But anyhow, I got to thank Billy and Jenny Wright for the opportunity. My dad, his own barbecue, he always helps us out a lot. My fiance Alexa, my son Landon's here. And everybody, all the fans for coming out and having a good night of racing.
Good solid run. Congratulations, Craig Cazone, coming up in a runner-up position.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Kelly Hahn. Steve Poulton, Aaron Foy, James Mathias. Making their way down the backstretch. Thank you. Sunday going around once again in the 77. Cars do have to be side by side at the cone on the exit of turn four there. Zach Dees inside, TJ Cruz outside. Two laps to go for TJ Cruz. checkered flag for TJ Cruz. Second, he's coming in second. Cutter on third. Fourth, Steve Gordon on fifth. James Matthews is sixth. Michael Manfeld is seventh. Jared Sheffield is sixth. Jared Sheffield eighth. Joe Sunday ninth. And Andrew Whitlock rounds out the field in third position. Already out of his car, TJ Cruz, your feature winner for the SRQ Taxis Scramblers. He's a little bit faster than I am trying to make my way down here. TJ, you're a young man out of that car faster than I can get down. Almost as fast as that Scrambler out front. Had a good restart right there with about halfway to go. Able to choose the outside and you fire off. I'm going to have a word with you real quick and then I'll do pictures. TJ, heck of a restart there. Was able to put this thing out front. Who do you want to thank?
Just my wife and my and Auburndale for us being able to do this.
Congratulations. What's that? Oh, yeah. Zach D's had a fast car tonight for sure. Oh, a little warm, too. Got a hole in the radiator. I got to mend that up before next week. Congratulations, Zach, on a runner-up. Looked like you were going to run away with this thing tonight, but always a restart and TJ was able to fire off on the outside and close the door on you, but you're able to come home in a podium finish.
Yes, sir. I appreciate him driving me clean the whole race. That was probably one of my best races ever. Fun being able to race against him like that and driving clean. That was just all around good race.
Who do you want to thank tonight?
I'd like to thank Bubba for letting me drive the car and everyone.
All right. I think we got it.
And Wayne, that always helps us work on all these cars and everyone that and tries to make it better every week.
All right, congratulations. Coming home. Hey, Kelly.
Right.
They told you to meet me. Well, you never know where. I was told I was in everybody's pictures last week, so I was told get out of the way. So I guess we'll stay in here in the middle. Who do you want to thank tonight, Kelly? Had a good, solid third place. Tried a couple things down the restart, but just couldn't keep up with these young men.
Yeah, just picked up a big push there after a couple restarts there and just didn't have enough. Thank the Lord for keeping us all safe, letting us come out here and do what we do. Thank the fans for everything, and thank my family for coming out tonight. Thank you guys for all you do, and do it again next time.
All right, congratulations. Good finish for Kelly on in the 5 car. Next up, Super Late Model coming out for feature race number 2, 50-lap Super Late Model. Got a little bit of water on the track here that Zach D's put down that Fred's going to blow away for us.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Jeff Schofield, John Guy, young TJ DeCure, Chase Lovelady. Thank you. this is deja vu all over again for TJ DeCare. Same situation last week in Pro Lama race. Leading with 13 to go, 14 to go. Caution came out. And Steve Gore made the pass for the restart. So, TJ DeCare, probably thinking TJ for deja vu all over again from last week. Richard Elk is loaded up here on the front stretch. Problems with it. 55. Pushes the front nerves. A little bit of smoke coming out of the back of the 27. So we're going to figure out what's going on with that car. So far, pretty good race, though. Nice. Laps with 14 to go. So, we're going to smoke the Guy 7th, A.J. Waller 8th, Tim Sozio 9th, Ray Holmes 10th, Dylan Bigley 11th, Ross Francisco 12th, Richard Elkins 13th, Patrick Starpoli.
TJ, Foshy came out with 14 to go. You had to think deja vu all over again from last week. But you're able to get this thing out front to keep it out front. Had the fastest car all night. Fastest car in the race tonight. Set the qualifying record. The move down here, Slip. Who do you want to thank tonight?
There's so many. Early this morning, having clutch issues, we didn't get much practice, but came out here, did our jobs. Rick Connect, Scott Clements, my parents, and everybody helps out in the car.
Good solid run. Good run in the earlier feature, came out. Congratulations. Go over there and take a picture, TJ. Jesse, all night long you were trying to reel him in, caught on the outside a couple times. Try to make moves on the end. But right at the end, you were able to make the pass for third.
Yeah, I want to thank all my guys, my brother Jeff. He got the car ready for me this week. I've been from town. And we're going to thank Mr. Carbone, Judy and Bruce Carbone, for letting us do this. Calvin, my sister came out. Everybody that helps me, Jimmy Cook, our core drilling, trim commissions, everybody that helps us out. Hit the wall in practice, hit the wall in qualifying, bend some stuff. My guys thrashed in the car, and we sucked the first race. So we changed all four springs, shocks, bumps, sway bar, stagger, trailing arms in between that practice, and put an entirely different build in the car from the first race to the second race. So if we just started this way, maybe we could have gone up here both races. We were way better the second race. I want to thank everybody for all the hard work.
Yeah, it was. It came out a little bit short, but a good podium finish. Jesse Dutilli, once again, congratulations.
Patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Hey,
Dustin Wilson, Jonathan Wallace, Tyler Landis, Dennis Wilson, Sean Osteen in the 22, Mike Wilson in the 68, Kalen Maynard in the 13, Kyle Rice in the 7K, Dalton McGraw in the 7. Green flag is in the air. Dustin Wilson inside, Jonathan Wallace outside. Tyler Landis in the third position. Right on the outside of Dennis Wilson. Jonathan Wallace on the outside, trying to make the pass for the lead. Dustin Wilson inside. Tyler Lynn is back in the third position. Dennis Wilson fourth, Sean Osteen fifth, Kyle Rice sixth, Mike Wilson, Roger Stargen. Still out front. Jonathan Wallace. Jimmy McLeod in the 04, both into the infield. Sean Osteen trying to make a pass for the fourth position. Dennis Wilson stuck on the outside. Kyle Rice right behind Sean Osteen. Around goes Kalen Maynard in the 13. I think we're going to stay green, though. Nope. Caution's out. Last time to claim your ticket. Last time to claim your ticket. 377-668. If that's not you, we're going to pull. If that's you and you don't claim it, we're going to pull another one here in a second. 377-668. Four laps in, 21 to go. Jonathan Wallace inside. Jonathan Wallace on the inside. Side by side with Dennis Wilson on the outside second row. Kyle Landis up to the third position. Sean Osteen looking to make a move for the fourth position on Dennis Wilson. Dustin Wilson outside second row. Oops. Kyle Landis up to the second position. Three wide for about the eighth on back position. Around goes three wide as they have to turn corner. Seven laps in, 18 still to go. Wilson has his sight set on Sean Osteen for the fifth position. Around goes Kalen Maynard once again in 13. Word is he has a little bit of help from the 53 of David Wilson. Position.
second. Around those shores, going to third. TW outside third row. Yeah, that thing sideways all through the heat races, and it features not much more driving a loose car in the 42W. Outside third row. Tyler Landis shuffled back to the fifth position after Chico. Restart is on the front two cars at the cone. The 42 of Dustin Wilson didn't go. Tyler Landis was trying to help him along, and they got hooked together. Laps down, 15, Jonathan Wallace. Out front, Sean Osteen. Kaelin Maynard going around in turn one. For Dennis Wilson, looking real flat in the 42. Got a battle for the second position. Three wide. Wilson sent three wide on Kyle Casey and Roger Targent. Jonathan Wallace, Mike Wilson, Sean Osteen. Squirrely here in the front stretch, overcorrected a little bit right in front of the field. Luckily, everybody was able to make evasive action. Settle this one. Green flag in the air. Six laps to go. It's been all Jonathan Wallace, Sean Osteen, Dustin Wilson, Mike Wilson, Dalton DeGroff, Cal Case, Tyler Landis. Cousin
Thank you. for 5 laps, single file. Well, maybe.
Going to have a single file dash for 5 laps, single file. Well, maybe if we can get Dylan Bigley in. Jonathan Wallace, come out of his car. Your feature winner, Jonathan Wallace, number 9. Jonathan, a chaotic race, but luckily it was on your rearview mirror. Restart after restart, you had it all behind you. You didn't get an opportunity to see all that transpired. Later on, maybe you'll get a chance to see it on Speedway video tomorrow, but it was hectic, but you had this car right where it needed to be.
Man, that was a long, long race. Probably the longest one I've been a part of in these Crown Vics, especially for a 25-lap race. And it was the car was there. It was really good. It started to push a little bit when I got to the outside, so I just knew where I needed to hit, keep on hitting my marks, and bring it home.
Congratulations. We appreciate you coming back to Auburndale. Who do you want to thank?
Oh, I want to thank everybody that puts a hand on the car. My mom, my dad, my girlfriend, my sister, my brother-in-law, Blue Gator, Captain Bob's Airboat Tours, Captain Bob, actually, his dad, we lost him about a couple months ago now, and it was his birthday the other day, so this win is going to be for him, so it's fun. Everybody that puts a hand on the car, Crockett's Towing, Professional Towing, everybody that just helps out, Farmer's Garage, everybody.
All right, congratulations. Third run. Sean, this was a race of attrition, endurance. You tried a couple things, had several restarts to try, so you kind of knew what was happening. Outside, inside, able to get this thing home in a podium finish. Jonathan had the car for the field tonight, but you're able to come home second.
I was doing everything I can to get around Wallace, but one of these days I'm going to get around him. I finished second to him a lot, so we're gonna get him one day.
Who do you want to thank tonight?
All my sponsors, Osteen's Load & Go, Barbers & Beers, Sweetie's Cafe. That's about it. Frank and Roger, Dan Wilson, are week in and week out, so that's all I got there.
Congratulations on a solid run. Coming home in third position, Mike. Man, you tried a couple different things too. Didn't know whether to try the outside, the inside. It was hectic out there tonight, wasn't it?
Absolutely nothing was working, but that was fun. I mean, we were beating and grinding and getting after it, but that was fun.
Who do you want to thank tonight?
Got to thank Cody Gray. He's the man working with me, putting all this thing together. And if it wasn't for him, wouldn't be here. I mean, his backyard race cars, they build good ones. And evidently, they're tough, too, because we took a beating tonight. But we sure had fun, though.
All right. Congratulations. Another side run for Mike Wilson in the 68. Once again, if you're making your way out, I want to thank you for coming to Auburndale Speedway. Please drive safe on the way home. See you next Saturday night for another eventful night of action.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.